Well, I have a data security lifecycle. The first part of that lifecycle is called the origin, and that's basically when you create the data. The second part of the lifecycle is called rest, and that's when it's sitting on your storage media. So you're just not interacting with it. It's on your phone, it's on your laptop, your tablet, your PC, whatever, your server. And it's just sitting there, nobody's interacting with it, nobody's using that data, it's not doing anything. Great. You probably hear data at rest in the news if you pay attention to this stuff lately, because it's becoming a bigger well-known item because people are talking about hackers and protecting your data when it's at rest. Data in motion, that's when you're using the data, transferring data, sending emails, logging into your server from outside of your typical locations, that kind of stuff. Using a virtual PC, that's when the data is actually in motion, when it's traveling. Data in use, it's when you're working on a document. And there are data security things that you should do for each one of these, right? But I'm not going to talk about those because those are too exciting. I want to talk about the boring stuff. Or the end of life, and it's basically when it's served its useful purpose, right? Technical folks like us, and I don't know how many of you out there are technical, but we're really weird about new equipment. When new equipment comes in, we immediately forget about the old equipment, and we go right to the new equipment. And so that's kind of what I want to talk about today, is end of life.
Donors and your patrons typically don't just reside in Naples, Florida. They're also in Ohio, North Carolina, New York. So you need to look at those state statutes as well. So you have to bring in counsel to let you know what data breach notification requirements there are. In Florida, there's specific requirements. And every
you gotta have some program in place that you're managing the vulnerabilities on your network. If you don't think you have any vulnerabilities, you gotta talk to somebody. Talk to me, talk to somebody. They come out every day. The NSA equation group, supposedly, had some exploits that were taken. I don't know if anybody heard of this. This is something we talk about. But supposedly, allegedly, the NSA has a hacking team that had these exploits. They were stolen, put on the web for everybody to see. So every Cisco firewall is vulnerable. The amount of things that they found exploits for is just amazing. And one came out yesterday about what's called a zero day for a Cisco firewall, which basically means that they don't have a patch for it. So if you have a Cisco ASA firewall, it's open to what's called remote command execution vulnerability. So